I travel my way through galleries of sound. I flow among echoing presences. I cross transparencies as though I were blind. A reflection erases me. I'm born in another. A masked lunatic searching for his face. I hear my name in the echoes of your body. I find your body in the nakedness of time. House of prophecy and lightning, forest of stone, blueprint of flesh. The endless corridors of memory. Doors to the valley of the dead. Opiate oblivion, burning in the depths of your heart. Orgasm found in the wings of a butterfly, writing fire on a piece of jade. Crack in the stone. Liquid nirvana at infinity's shore. Monolith of sacred memory. Plateau of erotic solitude. Romance of stone. Fertility of fire. Primeval sea below the void of space. Light of all beginnings. Lotus bathing in the house of cosmic water. Night undresses, drenched in death. Bleeding birth in the warmth of dreamless slumber.
Thank you. Thank you. fascinated by ambiguity, and I also like challenges in reading, which means that I like difficult words and unpronounceable words and nonsense words. Some of you may remember this text, which I'm sure you can't really read from where you are, but I'll explain in a moment, from about 12 years ago, passing around the internet. And it's one paragraph, which, when you overcome the difficulties of reading it, says, according to a research at an English university, it doesn't matter in what order the letters in a word are. The only important thing is that the first and last letters are in the right place. The rest would be a total mess, and you could still read it without a problem. This is because you do not read every letter by itself, but the word as a whole. Now, the way the first word, for example, according, is spelled here, is with the A at the beginning and the G at the end, but in between it's O-C-C-D-R-N-I-T. So if I were going to try to read it as it's written, I might read it as something like O-A-K-D-R-N-I-K. And then the word research, for example, is spelled with the R at the beginning and the H at the end, but in between it's S-C-R-E-A-E, which I could try to read as R-S-C-R-I-A. Were primarily interested in sound poetry, I might just read it exclusively like that. But what I was fascinated by about this is that they weren't thinking about it as extremely as they could be. Because if they were thinking about it more extremely, they would start using words that could resolve into multiple words. So in other words, the internal jumbling technique would not necessarily resolve into the word according, for example, it could resolve into something else. So I worked with a friend who was a software designer, and we came up with the available vocabulary in the English language of words which, when jumbled in the middle, could resolve into a minimum of two words, or as many as three or more. And then, two friends of mine, Keith Sanborn and Peggy Awish, were publishing a book about one still from Zeigo Bertov's Man with a Movie Camera, which some of you may know is an early 20th century Russian film of great radical formalism. And Zeigo Bertov is actually a reference to Spinning Top in Polish, so it's not actually a Russian name, even though it was a Russian filmmaker. So Keith emailed me a still from Man with a Movie Camera, and he emailed it to everyone that he was invited to be a part of this book, and then he asked everyone to write a text as a response to this still. I ended up knowing what the still was because I knew the movie. The still was extremely ambiguous. It's just basically lines. Someone not familiar with the film would have been hypothesizing about it being any number of things, possibly water or whatever. So what I did was, is I wrote a fairly comprehensible text describing my receiving the still, and then I rewrote the text using words from the vocabulary that Patrick and I had developed. And then I resolved that text into multiple versions of what the original text was. I'm not going to read the entire thing, this is quite long, but I'll read a few sentences from the more comprehensible version, then I'll read a few sentences from the jumbled version, and I'll go through all the different variations, just so you can have an idea here of what it is I'm talking about. So in the first version, it's called Distilled Life. It says, as the still from Man with a Movie Camera, emailed me by Keith, scrolled into appearance on my computer screen, it was initially ambiguous to me. Judging from the top third, I thought it might be reflections on water, and indeed, there's a scene in MWMC of machines intercut with a dam water applied to power them that comes close. Recognizing the full E as a school of something, I still don't remember exactly what scene it was from, and thought it might tie into the editing scene that ends the first frame. Okay. That's a fairly straightforward rendering there. But then the next version of it is called Refrain Asher Dem. And that reads like this. Let's see whether I can read this, because this is quite the challenge, since it's all more or less unpronounceable words, except for the ones that are only two and three letters, because, of course, you can't jumble the internal letter of a two-letter word, because there is no internal letter, and you can't jumble the internal letter of a three-letter word, because there's only one. So, as the spitter of Rimitriol, seek to Moramian, Pusek Troen to be my teeth, Omn Brunford on my Nilakmar, was Utkul Rul Ein to me.
Sounds like Klingon.
Snake I Utad form the top third, I Unelt it Ulad. Be skipped Peter on the blue, and the Flabriang trees a Flabriam in ESM of Fur Tree Sickled with the Noi Opum to Trial Uni Opol it could be. Right? And then the next version of it is Refiner Anarchism. As the sliver of brotherly spectre microcinema, uncorseted to me by Keith, unplumed, preformed of my microcinema, it was uncatalogued to me. Captaining from the top third, I unpulled it could be. Spectred on bubbler and veritably, there is a frameable in BSM of cutlery split with the unpulling emphatic to martial unpulling it could be. Adoption of the field as theater, I disremembered emphatically which spectre it was from, and catalog could be related to the reshaped spectre which wraps the first third. Skirtingly, it's from the time hole unelapsed. Alright, and the next version after that is re-infer arachnism. As the silver of rufflery sceptered micronemia, which means abnormal shortness of legs, for those of you who are unfamiliar with that term, unescorted to me by Keith unlumped perform on my micronemia, it was uncoagulated to me. Capitaning, form the top third, I unlooped in cloud, the scepter of blubber and verbality, threes of horrible NBSM, a cruelty split with the unlooping, emphatic to marital, unlooping in cloud B. Adaption of the file as teether, I disremembered emphatically which scepter it was for, and coagulated a cloud B realtor to the rephase scepter, which warps the first third. And then, finally, I wrote a version of it which, enclosed in square brackets, I give the pairs of possible words that these internal jumbling technique words could resolve into. So, as the sliver slash silver of brotherly brothelry, spectered, sceptered, micronemia, microcinema, unescorted, uncorseted to me by Keith, unplumed, unlumped, preformed, performed on my micronemia, microcinema, it was uncoagulated, uncatalogued to me, captaining, capitaining, from, form, the top third, I unpulled, unlooped it. Could cloud be spectered, sceptered on bubbler, blubber, and variably verbality? Threes theirs, a frameable, formable, in BSM of cutlery, cruelty, split, spilt with the unpulling, unlooping, emphatic, empathic to martial, marital, unpulling, unlooping, could cloud be? Adaption of the filed field as theater, tether. I dismembered. Emphatically, empathically, which specter, scepter was from form and coagulated catalog, it could well be relator, realtor to reshape, rephase, specter, scepter, which perhaps warps the first third. That's it. Thank you.
I like the last one.